Hello everybody, Andy Swim here inside the TV, and I'm just going to show you before I pack this. It is a Vortex glass bowl, and I believe it's a Pyrex glass. I just wanted to show you, like, and yeah, I'm going to pack it. It's a blue.
If you like it, clean.
Hello, Andy Swim here, and I am with
Ida
and Bobby Blueberry.
And today we're doing a dual review, and today I'm reviewing that blue Vortex bowl that I showed you earlier in the clip, and the Mad Hatter in the 100 gram plastic thing that was sent to me. Bobby will go over what he is smoking with and stuff. Beard.
Smoking this shit. Right here.
Rosetta?
Oh,
Rosetta? Summer watermelon.
Hope it's good.
Well, as far as Mad Hatter goes, I did a review on this a while ago, and my results for it were not so good.
Kind of beating me up because it tastes a lot like soap. I don't know, maybe it's just the way the flavors were mixed. It tastes like soap.
But what I'm smelling it this time around, I think it might have been the batch because this one doesn't smell that bad. It actually has a very winter green sort of smell in it. And I can't really get the other gists of what else could be in it. I think the Rosetta smells like bubblicious watermelon gum.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's I don't know. It's not as candy smelling as other watermelons I've tried, where they smell like a Jolly Rancher. This one's very sweet smelling. It's not like a Jolly Rancher.
It smells like a pack of Bubblicious to me.
Yeah, I agree.
I haven't tasted it yet, but if it tastes like that. And you're probably wondering what I'm holding in my hand. Well, this is the new hose, but I have a Gatorade bottle with another hookah hose tip on it that you can unscrew. Well, it didn't unscrew, it just kind of came out. But anyways, yeah, I just made this for shits and gigs, and it's pretty cool looking. Yeah. Within like 2 minutes of ripping this bowl, clouds were already producing massively. I had to put a windscreen on. As far as the Mad Hatter, I sort of taste the wintergreen, but it's not strong, and I can't really put my hand grasp on the other flavors that could be mixed with this blended shisha. It's almost like bakery type, so it has like a mint, but not complete mint, and then there's like a bakery taste in there, almost like a graham cracker. What do you think, Ida?
It tastes like the old
green gum. That's it. You don't taste anything else?
No. I haven't even tried this, so I shouldn't.
He doesn't exist.
But my beer exists.
Wintergreen
and chocolatey. Yeah, I can definitely taste that, like, that cookie. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's definitely a cookie going on in there
somewhere. A good recommendation when you're smoking hookah freak or hookah hookahs, 2 calls is really all you need. A 3rd call is pretty good to help heat it up, but a quick light would be better for that thing, but it is what it is. This watermelon, it tastes not completely strong, but it has the taste of a Jolly Rancher, which is very surprising because it smelled just like, it tastes like bubble gum, but it almost tastes like you just had like the after flavor of a Jolly Rancher.
Nine o'clock.
Sort of like a lollipop bubble gum one. So it's like a watermelon bullpup or a Jolly Rancher. I like it.
Can't handle this new faggot equipment.
It's too much.
The Mad Hatter is definitely giving me a buzz.
This is very similar to Half Baked. Half Baked had a very sugary cookie taste. This, like at first, it had like a little bit of a mint, but now I'm getting more of just like the cookie taste or a graham cracker.
Would you think that kind of Well, I'm going to jump down to a grading for Mad Hatter. And the flavors that I assumed, or you already said, that I taste at least. And I'm probably going to have to give Mad Hatter about a... I'm thinking 5.5 for Mad Hatter. Clouds are...
That's freaking 9 clouds. I mean, I'll throw the other coal on to get a little harsh. More cloudage for you.
Nine and a half claws of this.
This?
I wouldn't say this. I go into green
tea.
Give it a
six. I've become cloud, yo.
Like an eight
in your book. Yeah, I'd say flavor wise, we'll give it like, I think a 6.5 flavor wise. I don't know, clouds? Give it like a 7 or 8 on clouds. Well, as far as Rosetta's going, I've never tried this brand ever. It's my first time. And from what I'm tasting, I like it. I love it. I think for the Rosetta watermelon, I'm gonna have to go with about an 8 for the flavor. It's really good. I'd have to find out what other flavors Rosetta has. Try them out. And the clouds are pretty good too with this shisha. I'm getting like an 8.5, almost a 9 cloud piece.
This flavor, I'm gonna
give
it like a 9. It tastes really good.
Is that food?
Yeah, I love food.
Flavor wise,
you crushed the clouds. Oh, the clouds!
If I'm gonna give it like an 8 or 10. No, I'm sorry, 8 or 9. Let's give 9.
8 or 10.
9's a stupid number.
I'm gonna give it like an 8 or 9 for the flavor.
It's a really good flavor. It just took a while for it to heat up. And I'm very impatient, so that pissed me off, because 2 or 3 rips into his and he already had beast-ass clouds. Me, it took me like, close to 10 minutes to get decent clouds. I had to use a wind cover, but yeah, clouds now were like 8 or 9. So, not bad. Overall, 8 or 9 on flavor, 8.5 to 9 on that about sums up this lovely review. Have a good day / night. And
a great smoke.
Yeah.
Peace out.